Good evening, and thank you for joining us. I am Dr. Rushton Johnson, Vice President of Student Affairs at Pellissippi State Community College. In celebration of Black History Month, I welcome you to this unique performance of spirituals, theatrical selections, and freedom songs, including African-American composers and performers. This performance is under the direction of Brian Salesky, Knoxville Opera Artistic Director, and performed by members of the Knoxville Opera Company. In collaboration with our Audio Production Engineering Department, this performance is sponsored by Pellissippi State Community College, Blount County, Division Street, Magnolia Avenue, and Strawberry Plains campuses, and the Department of Student Engagement and Leadership for your enjoyment. At this time, I am pleased to introduce Maestro Brian Salesky.
Hello, I'm Brian Salesky, Artistic Director of Knoxville Opera. It's my great pleasure to welcome you here to Knoxville Opera's rehearsal building, which is just a very short walk from the Magnolia campus of Pellissippi State Community College. I'm very, very privileged to be able to bring you today's celebration of Black History Month at the invitation of Dean Rosalyn Tillman. I'm very, very appreciative of all the opportunities we've had throughout the years to perform for the faculty and students at Pellissippi. And today, we hope to bring you a program that will both inspire you and educate and truly be a joyous inspiration about Black History Month. Now, the subject of our concert today for you is, in fact, the musical experience of the Black American, which goes back hundreds of years. And we, of course, don't have time to do all the kinds of music that Black Americans would have experienced and created. And so we're going to focus on three particular areas of their experience. The first we're going to hear from today is a group of pieces that fall into the category of spirituals and gospel music. The first two numbers we're going to hear are Come Down Angels and I Want Jesus to Walk with Me. The first will be sung by my colleague soprano Adia Evans, and the second by my colleague baritone Michael Rodgers. I hope you will enjoy. Thank you.
Come my trials, Lord, walk with me. In my trials, Lord, walk with me. When my head is bowed in sorrow, Lord, I want Jesus to walk with me. Trouble, Lord, walk with me. When I'm in trouble, Lord, walk with me. When my heart is almost breaking, Lord,
as opposed to most spirituals, which date back to the 19th century, pre and post Civil War time, some of our greatest gospel songs date from the 20th century. And we're now going to hear two of those. The first is He's Got the Whole World in His Hands, in a marvelous arrangement by Margaret Bonds. And then the classic, probably the most famous gospel song by the great Dr. Thomas Dorsey, Take My Hand, Precious Lord.
He's got the whole world in his hands. Thank you.
Now we're going to go back to that great, great repertoire of the spirituals and hear two classics, very familiar to all today. The first that will be sung by Adia is Deep River, and then we'll close this section of our program with the great Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho in an really, really inspiring arrangement by Mark Hayes. I hope you'll enjoy.
Thank you.
I want to cross over into
the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. You may talk about your man of Gideon. You may talk about your man of Saul. There's none like good old Joshua at the Battle of Jericho. Joshua fit the Battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the Battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. Up to the walls of Jericho he marched with a spear in hand. Go blow them ram's horns, Joshua cried, 'cause the battle am in my hand. Then the lamb ram sheep horns began to blow, the trumpets began to sound. Joshua commanded the children to shout, and the walls come tumbling down. Oh. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. Oh, Joshua, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. And the walls come tumbling down. And the walls come tumbling down. Tumbling down.
The next section of our program is devoted to music that encompasses the characters, the African-American black characters, who are part of the great heritage of musical theater in our country. Now, as we know, there is a horrific history of the prejudice against African Americans being participants in what we call today Broadway musical theater, right? It's a horrible history that we have. Despite this horrible history, there are very specific roles that were written for black singers. And although they were not permitted to do so very often up until a certain point, these roles managed to start to break down certain barriers. Now, we can go back to the early part of the 20th century, talk about Scott Joplin, the great black composer. His one famous opera, Treemonisha, is sometimes done, not often. Even though Treemonisha used black entertainers, singers, dancers throughout its production history, this was not a great breakthrough for the black artist, because the black artist was still being prevented from performing just anything they wished to perform on the major Broadway stages. So we do come to an important moment in the musical theater history with Showboat. The year is 1927, and there is a very particular role in Showboat by Jerome Kern, the role of the stevedore Joe. This is the dock worker who travels on the showboat, and he sings one of the most famous and greatest songs in all of Broadway musical theater history, Old Man River. The song itself has an illustrious history of its own, being sung by so many famous black artists throughout the past century, and we are so grateful that Michael is going to sing it for us today.
There's an old man called the Mississippi. That's the old man that I'd like to be. What does he care if the world's got troubles? What does he care if the land ain't? Don't look up and don't look down. You toll that makes the big boss frown. Bend your knees and bow your head and pull the ropes till you're almost dead. Let me go away from the Mississippi. Let me go away from the big man boss. Show me the stream called the River Jordan. That's the old stream that I long to cross.
He keeps on running.
and we land in jail. Agate's weary and sick of trying. I'm tired of living, but scared of dying. But old man River, he just keeps rolling.
Eight years after Showboat came the piece that would define the marker between the black singer having the opportunity to be taken seriously in the world of opera. This was really a landmark occasion. The piece was Porgy and Bess. The year was 1935, and the brothers Gershwin were perhaps the first to create a piece which we today call race-specific. That means that in their estate, they provided that the piece would only be able to be performed by people of the race of the characters. This was new. It was absolutely a revolutionary thing for them to do. And fortunately, this provided a huge opening for not only the great artists who were there for that premiere, but all of the ones who walked in their footsteps afterwards. We should mention that the two people who sang the songs we're about to hear, Abby Mitchell and Todd Duncan, had wonderful careers, and it probably was because of the opportunity that Porgy and Bess presented to them in 1935. The songs we're going to hear now, Adia is going to sing the beautiful lullaby called Summertime, sung by the character of Clara, and then Michael will sing I Got Plenty of Nothing, which is sung by the title role of Porgy. So here is Summertime.
Thank you.
I got plenty of nuttin', and nuttin's plenty for me. I got no car, I got no mule, I got no misery. There folks with plenty of plenty got a lock on their door, afraid somebody's going to rob them while they's out making more. What for? I got no lock on the door, that's no way to be. They can steal the rug from the floor, that's okay with me, cause the things that I prize, like the stars in the sky, all are free. Oh, I got plenty of nuttin', and nuttin's plenty for me. I got my gal, got my song, got heaven the whole day long. No use complaining, got my gal, got my Lord, got my song. Oh, I got plenty of nuttin', and nuttin's plenty for me. I got the sun, I got the moon, I got the deep blue sea. There, folks with plenty of plenty gotta pray all the day. Seems with plenty you sure got to worry how to keep the devil away. I don't fret about hell till the time arrives. Never worry long as I'm well. Never want to strive to be good, to be bad. What the hell's eyes, glad eyes alive. Oh, I got plenty of nuttin', and nuttin's plenty for me. I got my gal, got my song, got heaven the whole day long. No use complaining, I got my gal, got my Lord, got my song.
The last work we're going to hear from the world of musical theater is going to be an extraordinary piece that was premiered in 2014. Our journey of the Black American musical experience, certainly by 2014, is a completely different one than the one back before the Civil War and in the 50, 75 years after that occasion. Now, fortunately, we have a very rich library of works that are about the Black American experience by Black Americans. And this is one of the premier works. Knoxville Opera was supposed to produce Harriet Tubman back before, you know, we knew COVID was going to wipe us all out. So we will do Harriet Tubman. We just don't know exactly when, and we hope it will be in 2022. The work, Harriet Tubman, by Dr. Nkiru Okoye, is a stupendous opera that is about the life's experience of this extraordinary, iconic woman. One of the things that is extraordinary about this opera is that it takes the audience on a journey of her life from the time she was a little girl through the time that she became the famous conductor of the Underground Railroad. There are very few theatrical pieces that take us on such a journey of one person's life. I'm very grateful to Adia Evans, who has performed this work now so many times for our wonderful audiences throughout the East Tennessee region. And she's going to perform the final scene for you today from this extraordinary piece, Harriet Tubman, When I Crossed That Line to Freedom. The scene is the forest where Harriet and some of the people she's trying to get to freedom in the North are faced with the problem of one person who just doesn't have it in him anymore to make the struggling trip. And you will hear what she has to say to this young man as she takes out her revolver, puts it to his temple, and says, "You're coming with me."
Mm-hmm.
The final portion of our program today is devoted to songs that are about freedom. Of course, freedom is something that we all cherish dearly, and the Black American musical experience provided a lot of wonderful repertoire about this theme. The first song we're going to hear is called "O Freedom," and many people associate this spiritual with the post-civil rights movement in our country. The second song we will hear, again a spiritual, called "Free at Last," which you'll find in some of the hymnals that are still in use today. This "Free at Last" may be the most famous words ever uttered by the most famous speech ever uttered by the great Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King on the steps of the memorial in Washington during his "I Have a Dream" speech. That's how I came to know about this piece and found out its rich cultural heritage. And you'll enjoy this particular accumulation of arrangements of Free at Last. So now, O Freedom, followed by Free at Last. Thank you.
Thank God Almighty, I'm free at last. Thank God Almighty, I'm free at last.
To close out our program today, in honor of Black History Month, we're going to present what is known as the Black National Anthem. In 1905, the brothers Johnson wrote the words and music to Lift Every Voice and Sing. And since that day, the Black community has taken it as their anthem, and we are proud to present it as our closing number. Please enjoy.
Thank you so much for being here for our virtual night at the opera. Site campuses are very pleased that we were able to bring this opportunity to you. This is our way of celebrating Black History Month. We hope that you will continue to learn more about our history and enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you again for being here.